Good day from Chem Help ASAP. This video shows a few sample C13 spectra to reinforce knowledge about general chemical shift values for carbons in common functional groups. Let's start with the spectrum for a very simple molecule, 1-propanol. The solvent for this spectrum was CdCl3, and the carbon of CdCl3 is right here, close to 77 ppm. Propanol has three carbons, each of which is sp3 hybridized. We see these three carbons, three peaks, and all these signals have a chemical shift less than 77 as expected based on their hybridization. Note that the signals do not have a uniform intensity, so these three peaks do not have the exact same size and can't be integrated in the same way as a proton NMR spectrum. This is a nice simple molecule with a simple C13 spectrum. Next is a compound called valeronitrile, which has five carbons, including the nitrile. Again, the solvent is CdCl3 with a signal close to 77 ppm. The four sp3 hybridized carbons have chemical shifts of less than 77 ppm. Where is the nitrile carbon? It is this small signal. It appears at about 120 ppm, which is a reasonable shift for an sp hybridized nitrile carbon. In this spectrum, we can clearly see the effect that all carbons do not typically generate equally intense signals. The nitrile signal is smaller because quaternary carbons tend to give a weaker signal in a C13 NMR spectrum. The nitrile carbon, which has zero attached hydrogens, is a quaternary carbon. This fact can actually be helpful for assigning which carbon in a molecule is giving rise to a particular signal. The shorter peaks are likely the quaternary carbons. Here we have the spectrum for 2-chloropyridine, which has five carbons. We do see five peaks in the spectrum, and all are within the 120 to 160 ppm window for aromatic ring carbons. Note that 2-chloropyridine does have a quaternary carbon. The carbon attached to the chlorine does not have any hydrogens. It is quaternary. Which peak is likely the quaternary carbon? It's probably this short one at about 151 ppm. Note that 2-chloropyridine has no alkyl carbons, carbons that are sp3 hybridized. So there are no upfield signals, just downfield signals. Our last spectrum is 4' chloroacetophenone. The molecule has eight carbons, but notice that our spectrum has only six peaks, six signals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Why don't we see eight signals? It is because our molecule has a plane of symmetry. By symmetry, these two carbons on the ring will give a single overlapping signal. The same is true for these two carbons. All the carbons appear in the spectrum, but some signals overlap. We have one sp3 hybridized carbon, the methyl, and that appears far upfield between 20 and 30 ppm. Three of the carbons are quaternary, 1, 2, 3, and those quaternary carbons give these three smaller peaks. The ketone carbon stands out. Ketone signals give among the most downfield signals in a C13 spectrum, and this ketone is close to 200 ppm. All the aromatic ring carbons are around 130 to 140 ppm. That is our last sample spectrum. We mostly looked at the chemical shift of the signals and their intensity in the case of quaternary carbons. Unlike proton NMR, we did not rely on ideas like integration or peak multiplicity. We have now looked at 4C13 NMR spectra as a way to review representative chemical shifts of functional groups. Please leave a like or subscribe. If you have a question or comment, please use the comments section. Take care.